Good morning. The traditional curtain raise is a bit different this year. The 1-to-1 charity shield was played in Wales. It was controlled for the first time by a professional referee and it was indoors. Some things, though, never change. Manchester United and Liverpool are chasing a trophy and John Motson's in the commentary box alongside Mark Lawrence.
A little more history made at the Millennium Stadium. The charity shield being played indoors after heavy rain in Cardiff over the last 24 hours. We're all perspiring under the retractable roof. And however the FA finally distribute today's £1 million profit from gate receipts to good and worthy causes, there's been no generosity to others from these two clubs when it's come to the cornering of football proceeds over the last two seasons. Manchester United, treble winners 2 years ago, league champions 3 times in a row, Liverpool, triple cup winners last season, 2 of those trophies lifted here in Cardiff. The guard of honour through which the teams came, disability teams from Brighton and Hove Albion and Wimbledon, and the guest of honour, the England coach, Sven-Goran Eriksson. Among the notable absentees, Steven Gerrard, also ruled out of England's friendly against Poland, of course, and Robbie Fowler, who's with the Liverpool party, but not named among the 18-man squad. Sander Vesterveld is fit to resume in goal. There's a place at left-back, the new signing John Arne Riise, and a starting spot in midfield for Gary McAllister. Jamie Redknapp is among the 7 substitutes, of which 5 can be used today. Juan Sebastian Veron, United's £28 million record buy, is away with Argentina, but Ruud van Nistelrooy, bought for a modest £19 million, starts up front alongside Paul Scholes. They'll be on opposite sides on Wednesday. Andy Cole has not travelled after his wife broke her collarbone. Dwight York is on the bench, and David Beckham makes his 300th senior United appearance. And since we're talking about trebles, United have lost the last 3 charity shields, 2 to Arsenal and 1 to Chelsea. Andy Durso is the referee, Liverpool in their first choice red strip, and it would be disrespectful to start the season without mention of the Anfield Holy Trinity who passed away during the summer. Billy Liddle, Joe Fagan and Tom Saunders, 3 great servants to Liverpool Football Club, will be fondly remembered, Mark Lawrenson.
Yes, they will, John. All different contributions, the 3 of them will be sorely missed and help towards a legend that is the football club.
It's unusual playing under a roof, but Manchester United on the attack in the white chain strip with Van Nistelrooy getting his first touch, and it's Harman for Liverpool. They are breaking down the left-hand side with Danny Murphy, first of all. Owen with Heskey in the centre. This is a dangerous attack straight away. It's Murphy once more, and he was brought down. It's a penalty in the first minute. Off Roy Keane. A penalty in the first minute. 48 seconds on the watch. Andy Durso didn't hesitate. What a start to the charity shield.
And the key to the incident as well is the pace of Owen going past Dennis Irwin, which sped Murphy in the penalty area. He looked like he was going to shoot, just took the ball away from Keane, and there's no doubt about it, it was a penalty.
And it'll be taken by Gary McAllister, who ended last season on such a high note for Liverpool. Can he start the same way against Barthez? And he can. The goal actually timed at 1 minute 17. Gary McAllister, after Roy Keane conceded the penalty kick.
That was a class penalty as well by McAllister, but low as well to Barthez's right-hand side. And great start for Liverpool, just from a breakaway, which is very much symptomatic of the way they play.
Well, they said wanted to get the season off to a flying start. There you are. And Liverpool did, of course, take 6 Premiership points from Manchester United last season. They won at Old Trafford. Murphy actually scored the goal there, the man who was brought down then.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it from the players' point of view that primarily these games are seen as friendlies, but I think that's just raised the tempo of today's game.
Well, this capacity crowd almost in the Millennium Stadium certainly got something to talk about straight away there. Owen it was who made the charge down the left-hand side.
Well, you could almost see, John, that he realised he was faced by Dennis Irwin, you know, well into his 30s, and he thought, well, I can take you, which is exactly what happened.
Yep, Stan is underneath this. McAllister again. Now, is that offside? Ooh, bit of a late flag, but it is, Owen. Two assistant referees, by the way. It's Bill Barston on this side and Dave Bryan on the far side.
Durso, who had the eyeball-to-eyeball confrontation with Roy Keane last season, Mark, but Keane didn't have much to argue about with that decision, did he?
I think there's absolutely no complaint at all.
There goes Emil Heskey. Dennis Irwin. Gary Neville playing at centre-back alongside Stam, but here come Liverpool again, and the United back four looks a little unsteady here. It's another free, well, it's a free kick this time. Mikhail Silvestre on the edge of the area, and certain uneasiness there with Gary Neville and company, Mark.
Owen again, John, running at people, lots and lots of pace, a little touch away from
Silvestre. That was almost on the line. Almost. It should be another penalty. If it was on the line, it should really have been a penalty. But anyway, McAllister can be equally deadly at times from free kicks.
It is the time to shield, though.
Well, it couldn't be closer to the 18-yard line, could it? I think Andy Durso is saying to McAllister, just wait while I get this wall back.
I think the key as well here for Barthez is that the ball's actually in the middle of the goal, and it's a case of where does he stand and where does he position the wall.
And Danny Murphy, who scored at Old Trafford from the free kick, is standing just behind McAllister. Dietmar Hamann is behind them. And somebody going back on the line here. He'll play them all onside if he does that. Referee's still not ready. It's McAllister, it comes off the wall, and it was in fact a Liverpool head, I think, anyway. It's collected by Barthez and it's kicked. All came to nothing.
It was actually a poor effort from a person of McAllister's qualities.
And it was on this ground where he helped to change the face of the FA Cup final, along with Michael Owen. Against Arsenal. This time it's a free kick in favour of Dennis Irwin.
It just does go to show that as a forward there is no substitute whatsoever for pace. And if you possess it like Michael Owen possesses it, it will always cause problems for defenders.
This is Jaap Stam for United. To Silvestre. Giggs. Van Nistelrooy. Keane. David Beckham. Trying to find Scholes or Giggs perhaps. The last time I remember doing a match under a roof, Mark, was back in the World Cup of 94. They played in Detroit at the Pontiac Silverdome with a roof on in the American World Cup.
Well, it's the first time I've experienced it, John. It certainly does add to the atmosphere because obviously the sound's kept in.
Absolutely. This is Danny Murphy, and Emil Heskey is off down the middle.
I think for United, obviously, it's a slightly different system for them, just Van Nistelrooy up front and Scholes off him.
Van Nistelrooy now didn't quite get hold of that, and he's got to settle for a corner. Yes, those are the two who Alec Ferguson has started the season with up front. Spoiled for choice almost now, the United boss. David Beckham will go across to take the corner. Silvestre is forward, so is Stam. And Beckham picks back the Sonny Hoopier, who got the ball away with a header. He's the Liverpool captain today. This is Giggs.
Yeah, I think the new system with Van Nistelrooy and Scholes just off it is really to not really accommodate those two, probably more for Juan Sebastian Varane when he's available to play alongside, obviously, people like Keane and Giggs and Beckham.
There's certainly going to be keen competition for places. Season, of course, in which Sir Alex Ferguson had his last crack at the Champions League, and the final is at Hampden Park, Glasgow, next May. He also want to become the first manager to lead a club to four consecutive championships. Forward by Hoopier. Heskey is onside here. Stam let him go for a minute and he tried to lob Barthez.
Yeah, definitely onside when the ball was played, which is the key.
Yes, good call.
Just level.
Diggs is speaking to referee Durso, but it was a good call by the assistant on this side. Marcus Babbel with Scholes. Nick Barmby's operating on this right-hand side. Mark trying to push his England claims.
Yes, it's definitely Murphy on the left. And the thing about them as well for Liverpool is that they are both interchangeable.
Irwin. Beckham looking for Scholes. Thank you, Bert. At the moment, Liverpool are finding their men better than Manchester United. That was Owen, but not on that occasion. By McAllister, but couldn't find Owen. This is Stam. And Mr. Roy's in the centre with Giggs here. The Scholes tries to set something up. A touch by Heskey to Owen. Oh, they're spreading out well left Liverpool here. It was David Beckham who got a foot to that. Lisa on the far side.
Talked about Scholes just playing off on Nistelrooy. The other problem as well for Manchester United is when both Keane and Buck play, they both want to come and get the ball from Barthez and attempt to duplicate to each other's position really.
Against Gary Neville, finding Murphy. He looked left, there was nobody else there, but there is now, it's Reza. It's a good run. Oh, and it was Nicky Butt who intercepted right in front of Barthez.
Great pace by Reza. Extremely good pace, I think, put both Beckham and Dennis Irwin on as well, taking on an extra gear.
Yes, the left back who came from Monaco after almost at one point signing for Fulham, it would appear. One of the guys that will take the corner, Marcus Babbel is in the 6-yard box. Emil Heskey is going in that direction now. Andrew white shirts there, Barmby. McAllister. Gary Neville's header out. Van Nistelrooy. Push up, free kick.
I think as you'd expect scoring a goal so early, it's a much livelier and brighter start by Liverpool. You'll be able to find the men much easier than Manchester United at the moment.
Heskey.
You're not allowed to shoulder charge in football anymore.
Roy Keane. quickest of matches Roy Keane has had in Charity Shield. Sent off last year against Chelsea. And now conceding that first minute penalty. In the meantime, his free kick will have to be retaken. The referee is still having a word with Michael Owen. Here's Silvestre now. Beckham was coming in far side, and don't often see him heading for goal, but he certainly wasn't far away there.
Great ball from Silvestre as well. Pinpoint accuracy. Pick Beckham out, there's no doubt about it. And attacked the ball very well, David Beckham. I think Owen was talking to Andy Durso, John, and making a point about the challenge by Heskey on Silvestre, and said he only shoulder charged him. I mean, Silvestre just bounced off him.
Formidable presence up there, Emil Heskey, battling away with Stam on that occasion. This is Murphy. Too long for him. And show. Apple. Keane. Puts it back for Paul Scholes and finds Silvestre. Giggs, Keane, Scholes, Van Nistelrooy, oh good challenge, Scholes again! Good challenge by Onsho on Van Nistelrooy, but it fell to Scholes.
Good interchange of passing as well, wasn't it? Ball on the floor, into feet, little Scholes, nice around the corner ball, and broke for him, I think he actually clipped the back of Van Nistelrooy, but it's so important to Manchester United, the service, certainly to Van Nistelrooy, because if it's on the floor, Scholes will make the movement off him.
Oh, and here's a chance for Michael Owen, who's turned inside. Oh, he's got it again! Well, he can do no wrong in this stadium, Michael Owen. Turned inside Gary Neville. Yap Stam couldn't do anything about it either, and Liverpool are 2-0 up in the Charity Shield with 16 minutes gone.
Well, it was a ball from Vesterbelt flicked on by Heskey. Stam slipped, no doubt about it. Owen kept a presence of mind, turned Gary Neville, and he just passed the ball into the back of the net. Super cool finish by Owen.
Took it beautifully, having turned the cup final on its head in the last 7 minutes. Michael Owen now shows Sven-Goran Eriksson just what form he's in for England on Wednesday night. 2-0 Liverpool. Well, the Manchester United defence has looked a little uneasy, and now Paul Scholes rattling in on Dietmar Hamann, and Andy Durso goes for his notebook.
Not a good time to make a tackle like that. 2-0 down. I don't know if the referee's got any real option. It's a late tackle by Scholes.
Oh, it was a fairly stormy Charity Shield last year. Chelsea, Manchester United, when Keane got the red card. Scholes gets a yellow here. And Manchester United are 2-0 down and aren't really out of the starting blocks yet. Liverpool have had some probably more competitive action in the pre-season build-up than United. Played, of course, a fairly routine Champions League match the other night, or qualifier. This is Roy Keane, though. But Irwin backing up, Beckham outside him. Well, Liverpool putting a marker down for the new season, then.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. So they do look fitter at the moment. And I know when you score goals, it gives you confidence, and ultimately that will also help as well. But Manchester United have been very, very sloppy at the back, which is most unusual for them when you consider the penalty. Sloppy late challenge by Roy Keane, and then of course Yap Stam slipping and Gary Neville committing himself.
Gerard Houllier has been saying in discussions about Michael Owen and his long-term future just how well he's been playing in pre-season. He's back to the sharp figure we knew a year or two back. This is Beckham. He only needs the flicker of an opportunity, as he proved then again. Here's Giggs. Van Nistelrooy. No extra time was scheduled today, incidentally. It's penalty kicks after 90 minutes should the game be level, but already Manchester United have got an uphill climb. The game's still not 20 minutes old. This is Paul Scholes. Nicky Butt. Giggs. Barnby that got the tackle in. Oh, Nicky Butt's gone down on the edge of the area. The referee has seen nothing wrong with that, with that challenge, and there will not be a free kick.
I don't think there was anything wrong with the challenge. I think it was perfectly legitimate, extremely legal, and an outstanding challenge as well.
Yes, good tackle.
Phenomenal.
This stadium wins here in the Worthington Cup final, the FA Cup final, 2-0 up. Just, could be three here. It's Owen again, pestering the life out of Gary Neville.
Great touch as well by Heskey. You can see him just throwing himself into the ball and playing just a touch to flick it on above Yap Stam.
I remember Alec Ferguson saying that Gary Neville was one of the defenders Michael Owen least liked playing against. So he's certainly got one up on him so far today.
Can't get the rhythm going at the moment, Manchester United, and it's a passing as much as anything, because the system they're playing, the passing virtue has to be perfect, because both Honcho and Ipio know they can get extremely tight on Van Nistelrooy. As one of them is aware of the fact that Scholes may run in behind them.
It's a free kick in Heskey's favour against Dennis Irwin.
Well, the referee.
This is the right of the picture. Marcus Babbel has come up to support Heskey. Beckham. Looking for Roy Keane, who made a forward run. It's his header inside. Pitch cooking up a bit, Mark.
Well, when you consider as well that the roof's on, so you imagine what it would have been like without the roof in place.
An awful lot of rain down here in the last 24 hours. This is Keane. Beckham. corner. I don't think Manchester United wanted that free kick. Nicky Butter turned away and was in full flow.
No, first mistake the referee had made. He just put his whistle to his lips as Butt played Sylvester in.
Short one to Keane. On by Scholes to Irwin. Challenged by Murphy. Liverpool really up for it. Halfway through the first half.
They're also defending quite deeply as well, Liverpool. There is no space at all for Manchester United to play the ball in or even in behind them.
This is Nicky Butt. Sylvester. Only Van Nistelrooy at the moment in the centre. Here comes Giggs, but it's too long. Now Barthez has come tearing out of goal to the centre circle to tell Gary Neville something presumably quite important.
Well, Stam as well.
It's very, very warm with that roof on, I must say. Andy Durso just taking a bit of liquid. Sylvester. Giggs. Challenges by Harman. That's going to be a free kick to United. Scholes to Irwin. Now Keane's gone down and the assistant referee on the far side, Dave Bryan, has given the signal to Andy Durso. It's a free kick. So Yap Stam and Sylvester are both coming forward here for Beckham to plant the ball in. Oh, and the header by Keane, and turned over acrobatically by Vestergaard.
Three great bits of skill. As you can imagine, the free kick from Beckham whips in right foot. A great header from Keane and just reaction save by Vestergaard.
Well, he missed the pre-season games, the Dutch goalkeeper with a groin injury, but no sign of it there. Van Nistelrooy in the crowd. Comes out to Button, now to Giggs. Van Nistelrooy's there again, and so is Keane. Beckham. And the header out comes to Sylvester. Oh, well, a loud shout for Hans there against Stefan Oncho, but not from the players, only from the crowd. Goalkeeper was already on his way down when that hit his defender. This is Giggs now as Manchester United turn up the temperature a little.
We thought about it, no doubt about that whatsoever.
It might have come off his thigh up onto his arm, Mark, accidentally, yeah?
It did, most definitely.
Just one or two arms raised there by hopeful Manchester United players, but Oncho got away with a pretty controversial alleged handball in the cup final, I remember, on his goal line. Sylvester's pass looking for Giggs and goalkeeper well out. Barnby. Offside.
Good run by McAllister as well. He waited for Heskey to hold the ball up, play it back, and he was away.
Silvestre. Van Nistelrooy coming in from the far side now. That's far too long.
It was a poor cross by Silvestre, but there weren't too many options. I saw two white shirts, Scholes and Van Nistelrooy, and at least four or five red shirts.
Free kick, David Beckham's got a choice. He's got Yap Stam in there, Van Nistelrooy as well, but onto the head of Sammy Hupiet. The ball's been in the Liverpool half for quite a while. Release Barnby on this side against Silvestre.
That was a great pass by Risa. Brilliant way, picked Barnby out.
Yes, once you wonder if Risa's going to play at left back, whether that means a change of role for Jamie Carragher or give Joao Julia another option.
Another problem, I think, as much as an option.
Carragher among the seven subs, by the way, which, as I said, have been named today with the option of using up to five. This is Ryan Giggs. Good tackle. Harmon. And now McAllister to Murphy, and on to Owen. Barnby. Marcus Babbel making a run down this side. Roy with his back to goal, looking for a free kick, doesn't get it, and the one against one here is Heskey and Stam. Had time to turn, Emil Heskey, and Michael Owen is off to the left. We'll be hoping that none of his squad for Wednesday get injured today. There's Roy Keane. Scholes. There's a lot of players going away on international duty after this for various countries. This is Keane again. Doesn't get anything from referee Durso.
Thought it was going to be John, but I think I'll put that as much down to the fact that there's a goal scored so early in the game, which then changed somewhat the tactics of the people that concede that goal. And there's always going to be a bit of feeling between these two sides, there always has been, and there always will be. I just feel that Liverpool very, very much in charge, really. Lots of possession by Manchester United, but apart from one chance for Roy Keane, I think Liverpool have kept Manchester United playing, look very dangerous themselves going forward.
And here they come again, this is Babbel. Harmon. Murphy. McAllister. Husky's coming in from the far side, and it was Gary Neville who got for him to concede the corner.
The ball from McAllister, and also an excellent run by Husky, trying to get that across the face of the Manchester United defence. It took by Gary Neville.
We have got two masters of the whip cross today, haven't we? McAllister and Beckham.
You won't find too many better in the Premier League.
It's a corner now then, and Babel and Hupia are moving around the six-yard area. Heskey gets up with the crowd, here comes Hupia. And Andy Derso has given a corner on this side. Give you the ball back when I'm ready. So Babel stays forward. Rupia looking for a position just beyond him. Barthez coming to meet Heskey.
And that was Barby, and it was headed off the line. Irwin, I think it was.
Free kick's been given anyway. I think it was Dennis Irwin off the line, Mark.
Yes, it was. Just like that extra couple of inches of height, I think, by Barmby. And Barthez has committed himself. He hasn't been in the game very much at all. And it's a big ask to come and get that above Heskey, but Irwin, presence of mind, stayed his ground and made the clearance.
Yes, it was an error of judgment, or perhaps of handling, really, by the goalkeeper. Mm. He didn't quite make it, did he?
Don't make a save unless you have to, I think it is.
Playing it across the face of Michael Owen. So 2-0 to Liverpool and one off the line. Here's Silvestre. Thank you, Bert. With the tackle, going to be a yellow card. He got himself sent off in the home game against Manchester United last season. Was a bit late there on Beckham.
Yeah, he's caught his foot, doesn't he? So, giving in a books goal for the yellow, which he rightly did. Then Murphy also has to go in the book. He got a berating as well, didn't he, the referee from Roy Keane. I think they wanted, obviously, to play advantage.
Here's Keane now. Always hit the bar. Fine effort from the Manchester United captain. Beckham to cross again. Well, that certainly rattled the crossbar from Roy Keane. Manchester United's best effort to date. Relief for Westerveld. This is Nicky Burt. McAllister picking up the loose ball and getting just caught there by Stam.
The score came from a loose pass, I think, by Dennis Irwin.
This is Marcus Babbel. Keane. And Nistelrooy starts a run on the shoulder of Hoopier. This is Giggs. And it's Giggs again from the back heel by Silvestro.
Been very quick, Liverpool, and down the right-hand side of their defence. As soon as Giggs gets the ball, and this is a shot from Keane that seems to dip, and it dipped ever so late, and Bessevel had given it up. It very early, Keane, as well, outside of his foot, and the swerve and the pace, and it...
Goldie was nowhere near that, was he?
No.
Good effort by Keane, unlucky. This is Giggs, won back by Harman, Murphy, McAllister. Emil Heskey's pulled something, I think his left thigh there, Mark, he's hobbling a bit. Babel. Taking on Stam.
Yeah, there's no doubt that Hesse's got a problem, and we're going to have to jump with it being pre-season, anything untoward, and just take him off.
Yes, the England game coming up, of course, on Wednesday, and no Robbie Fowler among the substitutes, which was something of a surprise.
And I don't think Gerard Houllier will be worrying about the England game.
Here's Van Nistelrooy. Oh, it just caught Hoopier on the way through to it.
Great touch actually by Hoopier, just diverted the ball away from Van Nistelrooy, very important.
It's a foul by Heskey.
He's all right now.
Yes, yeah, seems to be.
Middle name's not Lazarus, is it?
This is Silvestro.
There's not the fluidity of movement for Manchester United. They're very much a passing and movement side, and we've spoken a lot about the fact that change the system. It is going to take them some time, I think, to adjust.
Well, if he wants to revert, Alex Ferguson, he's got the likes of Solskjaer and York on the bench. The second half. This is Silvestro now, leaving it to Roy Keane. A couple of minutes left in the first half for Manchester United to make some sort of impression. Giggs tries to find Keane. Babel was the player in the way, and in the challenge which followed, Silvestro got an injury, and there's nobody in the left back position as a result of that. Nicky Barmby's playing on. Danny Murphy. Owen is to his left, so is Heskey. Offside, Heskey.
Waste, really, because Heskey, you could see across the line, there's no real need to be caught offside. He could have still given himself a yard the other side and got the ball, the through ball from Murphy. It's amazing, John, how he's had a winning shot there and caused all those problems in the first 10 or 15 minutes. He's hardly had a touch since.
And Van Nistelrooy's not getting any change out of the Liverpool defence either, is he?
Well, he's having to battle against two of them at the moment, and no doubt that United are going to have a serious rethink for the second half.
A little bit of encouragement for the rest of the Premiership, I suppose, to find the untouchables of last season, two goals down.
And they always do this in the Charity Shield.
Well, I was going to say, they have lost the last three, haven't they? It's usually no real guide, but...
Called the Sting.
This is Barnby. Now into the search for McAllister, looking for Heskey. Lisa on the left. David Beckham trying to pick out Van Nistelrooy, but once again the cover is on for Liverpool.
Job Harman in front of the Liverpool back ball, very unspectacular, but the ball's there to one, he seems to be able to win it, and seems to be able to win it legally.
Not many stoppages in this first half, just a minute to be added on. Michael Owen and Yatchdan. Silvestre, last attack of the first half, almost certainly. Giggs. Oh, Van Nistelrooy, a good dummy, goes for the return. And Liverpool continue to make the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff something of a second home. Gary McAllister with a penalty awarded in the first minute of the match. And then, almost inevitably, the quicksilver Michael Owen making it 2-0, leaving the champions somewhat disgruntled with their best attempt when Roy Keane hit the bar. Well, this 1-1 Charity Shield match being watched by a crowd of over 70,000 in the Millennium Stadium. What a great turnout, especially as the supporters have all had to travel quite a distance. And it's Liverpool now playing from the right in the second half, having finished last season with 9 wins and a draw in 10 games, winning 2 cups in the process. They now face 6 games in 20 days, Liverpool, including a Super Cup match against Bayern Munich, which you'll see live on BBC television. Monaco. That was Barnby for Liverpool. Just wonder, Mark, whether the managers will take up the option of these 5 substitutes as the second half wears on.
I think it's a certainty, John. I spoke to them, sat this player down and talked to them and said, let's keep with the system, see if we can work it out. And Liverpool will just be more of the same, please, but definitely substitutions will be all over the place eventually.
Silvestre makes a forward run for United. He's got Van Nistelrooy to his right. Here he is now. Got right underneath it.
Good play as well by Silvestre. Past Barnby and Aman. And he picked Van Nistelrooy out. A lovely little movement from Van Nistelrooy. And made too much of it.
was Heskey. Owen trying to get in the other side of Stam. There's an offside flag up there. On the chest of Heskey, up against Irwin. Murphy's cross. Keane. Scholes still playing in that withdrawn position behind Van Nistelrooy. Giggs. Oh, and Van Nistelrooy's in here. And Vestergaard got something on it. It's a corner. Could have been the moment when Manchester United got back in the match.
Yeah, lovely movements as well. He's just on side level, Van Nistelrooy. Lovely save by Vestergaard though.
It's too long for Stan. It's going to come to Giggs. Vestergaard's having a good match, especially as he missed most of, well, indeed, all the pre-season games and the Champions League match the other night. Irwin. But to Stan. Gary Neville. Well, the second half has started with two opportunities for the new man up front. Hasn't taken either of them as yet. This is Beckham. But United really carrying the game to Liverpool here. This is Keane. Well, it's a decent little ball, and it's Nicky Butt, and it was Paul Scholes. Usually so accurate.
That was outstanding interplay, wasn't it? Kept hold of the ball, Manchester United. Waited for a run there. It came from Butt, pass from Keane, lovely little ball into Scholes, and he snatched someone out at it.
Three chances, though, in the first 4 minutes of the second half for Manchester United.
Yeah, I think you can safely say they've had a talking to at half-time.
This is Irwin. Goals. Heskey with Owen to his left. And over on the right is Nicky Barmby. Oh. Touch back for Giggs, and here's Van Nistelrooy again. Surely this time, yes. Third time lucky for the £19 million man. And Manchester United get back into the charity shield in the 6th minute of the second half.
Well, it was coming, wasn't it? Superb play again by Manchester United. This is the pass, it's a great little ball, and just his onside Van Nistelrooy. Waits for Vestergaard to commit himself, and as cool as you like, when he's fit. The passing and the movement is more like the Manchester United we know.
Well, we'll hear this name over the loudspeaker in situations like this fairly often, I would venture to suggest. That was quality finishing by the Dutchman. And very much game on now. Liverpool made a whirlwind start to the first half, but Manchester United have done exactly the same in the second.
I think just the passing and the movement, John, in the first 6 minutes have been far better than anything they accomplished in the first half of Manchester United.
And Liverpool are just pegged back in their own half and have been almost since the team's restarted. This is Babel. Keane. Liverpool have now got to dig themselves out. It's Heskey trying to get to Gary Neville. And the noise booming around the stadium, which of course with the roof on it, lends the atmosphere even more flavour. And Van Nistelrooy making his mark then on the domestic scene. Beautifully taken.
Simon, a good goal scorer as well. He had that half chance earlier on, completely put it to the back of his mind.
Here he is again against Kupia. Onsho gets a foot in. Beckham. And now it's Irwin. This is incessant. Murphy.
All of a sudden, Liverpool's final pass is going astray now. And all it's doing is setting Manchester United back on the way forward.
Well, I think he had a few words to say at half-time, as you suggested.
Well, I think just the fact that they had to raise the tempo, Manchester United, and play at a much higher pace than they showed in the first half.
This is Heskey up against Stam. Oh, well, Barthez likes it there. Not sure this Dan does though. Michael Owen wants it played just inside. Now then, Beckham charging from midfield. Well, it's Manchester United now who look as if they've got a man over all the time. But to Scholes. Liverpool really looking to mount their first attack of the second half here. It's Sami Hupia who's come out from the back. Barnby. Risa, Murphy, Harman, McAllister. Giggs, Keane, Nicky Butt. Keane's made a run through the inside left position. That's fallen for Murphy. tries to get Barnby away.
I think in the context of the game, Liverpool need a little spell of just keeping hold of the ball. Definitely a resurge at Manchester United in the second half with that reply from Van Nistelrooy. It's just important that for Liverpool to calm the game down and slow the game down and try and play the game at their own pace.
This is Beckett. Three the other way. Giggs coming in from the far side. Bit tight here for Heskey, but down Murphy. With Owen around, you've got to be certain, which Stam was, although Owen is appealing to the assistant referee that Barthez took that outside the line.
No, absolutely no way.
And that's a foul by Harman, who's going to get a booking. Referees, of course, better paid this season on the way to full-time professionalism of a sort, and that's Barthez. Well, you can see what Owen was shouting about, but it wasn't given. Here's Key.
Keith is still in the air, aren't
yes. This is Irwin. Roy Keane really snapping at Harman there. Oh, every challenge is meaningful. There's no way they've regarded this as a pre-season exercise. And you wouldn't expect them to when Manchester United and Liverpool meet. The supporters wouldn't stand for it. This is Scholes into Giggs. That's made a forward run also. Marcus Babbel. Barnby's outside him. Heskey in the middle. Liverpool will settle for the corner. Sammy Hupia, who scored in midweek in his home country, is up in the six-yard box here, number four. Babbel to come from deeper, number six. It was Heskey who actually had the header. And now the match gone. Liverpool lead 2-1. This is Beckham. The shot is on. Oh, it's come off Danny Murphy. and Nistelrooy. Oh, he shook off Owen, he found Gibbs. That's a good reverse ball, and Scholes is in there, Beckham's there.
That's a good little play by Beckham in the end, because he has to change his feet initially on Nistelrooy, and cross came in, Scholes fighting for it, Risa with the header, and Bruce had to adjust, and really and trying to adjust, too much elevation on the shot. It's very important for Manchester United in the second half. You've seen already, John Beckham's got in the penalty area, Scholes obviously, Butt's been in there as well, and Keane, and it's a completely different Manchester United side in terms of movement.
Yes, and Gary Neville just at the minute has got Owen bottled up. Stam is playing pretty close to Heskey, and the Liverpool attack still looking to make an impression in the second half. This is Babel to Barmby. Oh, it's well played between the two. He won't get the free kick though. It's Manchester United who come away with Keane. Now Beckham, there are four of us up to his left. Irwin joining in. Finding Butt. Giggs out left. Goals. And now Beckham. That's a good effort. Oh, I think depending where you were in the stadium, you might have thought that was going in.
Well, I'm sure Sander Vetterveld thought it was in. This is the key, undoubtedly. Great first touch. He had a look. Knew exactly where Vetterveld was, tried to curl it behind him, and I'm convinced Vetterveld thought that was in.
I think a lot of us did. Super effort by David Beckham. Well, while Manchester United have got the impetus, it looks to me as if Alec Ferguson is preparing Dwight York. Away through, it's Giggs who finds Silvestre. All United at the moment, Liverpool backpedalling furiously. Oncho makes the clearance, but there's the same uncertainty back there now as there was in the United defence in the first half. Van Nistelrooy. That looks to have gone out to me for a goal kick. Now.
Sorry, John. I think United will go for broke. It surprised me if Nicky Butt came off actually, and Scholes can go back into his position.
Yes, you've called it.
Up front.
You've called it spot on. While that was happening, Dwight York came to the line, and it is Nicky Butt who's going off. Dwight York. 20 minutes into the second half, the first of what could be up to 10 substitutions today. So this is going to be a York-Van Nistelrooy link-up now.
Well, all reports out of Old Trafford would suggest that the games are played at the start of the season, that York's looked extremely sharp, and his pairing with Van Nistelrooy has looked the most likely. Liverpool can't keep the ball. It's a great problem. It's going back to Manchester United, and at the moment they look like creating every time they get the ball.
But here's Danny Murphy. Oh, the foot up there. Well, again, I don't think Liverpool wanted the game stopped. Murphy was on his way, and it was a foot up by Keane on McAllister, which Andy Durso had pulled them back for.
I thought he brought up Louis whistle a bit late, actually.
So it's a free kick. Babel going up on the far side. Up goes McAllister, but that's a push. Just coming up to the halfway point in the second half in Cardiff. The sound echoing under the roof of the Millennium Stadium, mostly being made by Manchester United supporters in this second half. This is York. What a good-looking ball. It's Roy Keane who made the forward run. And for the moment, in possession terms, the champions have it over the cup winners, but they're still 2-1 behind. McAllister. Now then, Owen, Heskey's to his right, through the middle. Can he get him the other side of Stam? No, he can't. And Barthez decides, again, to show off his outfield skills.
I think the pass needed a couple of extra yards on it, didn't he? Give Heskey a chance.
That's a raking ball by Beckham. And here's York. And again, Dwight York. And Scholes following up here for Manchester United. Good save, Vesterbelt. Well, Michael Owen is breaking at the other end with Heskey to his left. They're still clearing the penalty area at one end, and here comes Heskey at the other. Rolling it back for Harman. And Dietmar Harman going through, and Gary Neville makes the challenge. Barthez out. Well, it was a little more than 30 seconds of exciting action there at both ends. Paul Scholes looked to me to be odds on to make it 2-2 there. Giggs, here's Scholes again. Another good bit of goalkeeping by Sander Vesterbelt there, keeping Liverpool's lead. But one wonders for how long. If United continue to dominate like this, this is York. Goals. Beckham with the cross. Too long for Dwight York. There's another good bit of goalkeeping mark there against Scholes.
It was an excellent save by Vesterbelt. He waited as long as he possibly could. And play by Nissi by York. The way he took the ball as well, Scholes did it very, very early. But that was the key, John. Just stayed on his feet, Vesterbelt.
Are all over them at the moment. Van Nistelrooy, oh no, the referees, well, once again, Andy Durso has made the Manchester United players very cross by pulling the play back for an offence in their favour when they would have preferred to have played on. That's what Beckham and Giggs are saying to him.
I think the problem is that he still had a man to beat Scholes, and that man just knew the whistle had gone, the Liverpool defender, and let Scholes go past him. So there wasn't that great an advantage.
Well, it gives Beckham and Giggs the chance to size up the prospects from the free kick, which Beckham takes, and that goes straight through. I think there might have been a foul on the goalkeeper there by Dwight York at the last. Now Liverpool to make their first change.
Same double substitution for Liverpool.
Or even changes.
Replacing number 20, Nick Barmby, it's 25, Igor Gieske.
Barmby off. And Murphy off.
13, Danny Murphy is number 15.
Pete Channon. And also Patrick Berger, whose pass provided Michael Owen with the winning goal here in the FA Cup final, Mark.
Yeah, Berger down the left, Biscan down the right hand side. And qualities obviously Berger's got with that left foot. And Biscan big and strong. And we're getting involved probably even a little bit more centrally than maybe Murphy did.
So two East Europeans coming on. Liverpool play the cosmopolitan game that it now has become. Should bring some more energy to the central part of the Liverpool team, which was being a little overrun in the last, well, in fact, most of the second half.
under 46 minutes.
Absolutely. We're into the last 20 now of the Charity Shield. Van Nistelrooy looking for York. In by Owen, a little touch on, and thought it was going to fall for Ryan Giggs, but that's Van Nistelrooy, who's been bundled over by Beechchan, who's allowed to play on. This is Owen.
I think Giggs thought about shooting and he realised it was his right foot and decided not to bother.
Well, Barthez has saved time by taking the throw-in himself. He could be a pivotal figure if Manchester United were to score again, because the Charity Shield could then go to penalties.
Probably want to take one as well.
Oh, I'm sure he will. This is Beckham. Now then, Patrick Berger. Beckham. On this side of the field, Dwight York is getting into the game now. Roy Keane. Irwin. York. Beckham taking up a more central position again, but couldn't slide that pass through, and it's going to be Harman to put Heskey away, and Barthez was out of his goal. He's racing back now, as indeed is Stam. Liverpool are trying to get players forward in support. McAllister's there, and so is Owen, and Heskey trips over the ball. And then gets upended by Jaap Stam. It's a frustrating sort of tackle that. It's given Liverpool a free kick over on the touchline.
Well, Heskey did well in the end, as he's missed control at one stage. Looks like Liverpool going to lose the ball, then he managed to protect it and get an advantage for his team.
Well, Gary McAllister is the man to take these. Referee seems unhappy with the ball at the moment. So McAllister will deliver the free kick with a replacement. Talking of replacements, Beechchan is up there in the penalty area for Liverpool. And Hoopy are trying to get there. Berger. Irwin. Of passes from Roy Keane, and this is Patrick Berger with Heskey spinning off to his left. Challenge was, in fact, it was Keane who made the challenge, and Manchester United didn't even have to. Oh, and Barthez is contesting with the referee face to face. It's another example here of where Andy Durso has stopped the play to give a free kick when the team in whose favour it was would have preferred to have played on, Mark.
Well, you can moan, can't, well, he's given a free kick the other way, John, now.
Well, maybe he's given it against Barthez for ungentlemanly conduct.
Well, that's all I can think about.
Well, they have had their confrontations before, Mr. Durso and Mr. Keane. This is what happened between Keane and Berger. Pulling of the shirt by the, well, both players, actually.
I think Berger started it, so he's been penalised.
So after all that kerfuffle, it's a free kick to Liverpool.
And they will confront the referee if Liverpool score from this.
Oh dear, dear, yes they will. Harry McAllister putting the ball down very deliberately. This is all of 30 yards. And coming off the wall, it's come back to Harmon. Now then, they can break. Roy Keane, Van Nistelrooy waiting. First touch, Prop led him down there. He had Giggs to his left. And now, almost at once, is McAllister for Liverpool with Heskey gone left, Babel going right. In fact, he came further in than McAllister ideally wanted him. But Owen on this side of the pitch has got his arms up. He's unmarked at the moment. Game's very open and stretched now, Mark.
Yeah, the problem for McAllister then was, it was a very clever run by Emil Heskey. He seemed to run across people where McAllister wanted him to go a bit wider so McAllister could then commit somebody.
...12 minutes left in the Charity Shield in the Millennium Stadium. Barthez comes for the long throw and finds Dwight York with his. Liverpool still protecting a 2-1 lead here. Key.
There's no doubt the game's starting to stretch out that as much as anything is due to two things, pre-season and tiredness.
Yeah, although the FA Cup final went a bit like that towards the end, didn't it, on this pitch. This is Beckham. Giggs trying to force the through to York. This is Van Nistelrooy. It scores and it's deflected by Risa. This is going to be a corner if it goes.
I don't think Van Nistelrooy realised he had a bit more space than he thought.
They've taken a short one here. It's Beckham. Back to Irwin. And now Giggs. Well, Liverpool have got nobody upfield at the moment, and when they lose the ball there, it's a present to David Beckham, which he promptly returns. You just get the feeling, Mark, that way you're sitting here in the cup final, there's another goal in this somewhere. This is Keane. And if it's going to come, it looks more likely at the moment to come at this end. It's a corner to Manchester United.
More purpose about their attacking play, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's been the story of the second half. This is Beckham to take the left wing corner. Roy Keane gets there, but so do two defenders. And we're into the last 10 minutes now. Barthez is in the Liverpool half at the moment. Van Nistelrooy between two defenders, goalkeepers. And he's had an excellent afternoon, Vestervelt. He's in the Dutch squad for Wednesday at White Hart Lane. There's Berger. Now then, that's a raking pass to find Beechjan. We've got Owen just inside in here, Beechjan again. What a noble effort, started it and finished it.
Yeah, good player, wasn't it? I think straight away when he received the ball from the pass of Berger, he committed the defender. That was the most important thing.
This is David Beckham. This is Keane. And it's Scholes, and it's Keane again! Good save, Vestervelt. My word, he's been tested this afternoon, and he's not been found wanting, the Liverpool goalkeeper. 3 or 4 outstanding stops. Giggs. Gary Neville. Nearly got round the back there, but Engstrom and Vestergaard finally getting the ball away for Liverpool, but they're still under siege. I really think Bartes is going to come out and play in the forward line in the last 5 minutes, Mark. He's very rarely in his penalty area at the moment. This is Scholes for United. And Giggs. And Beckham. And Neville. Three goals in nearly 300 club appearances, Gary Neville. And this might have been one to add to the tally.
Now this is the earliest ever at Vestergaard. This is his forte, John, shot stopping, no doubt about it. Lovely positioning.
So Risa going off for Liverpool. And Jamie Carragher will get a run out. 7 minutes to go.
He's shown a lot of promise, Risa, and some very good things. He looks good going forward. And just in the last 10 minutes, he started to give the ball away. I would presume that's because he started to tire. And we all know about Jamie Carragher's capabilities at left back.
Well, it was at this stage in the FA Cup final, when Arsenal were apparently coasting at 1-0, that Liverpool produced the two deadly blows. And here's Michael Owen at that very end. Today it's Liverpool who lead, but it's a little fragile at times in the second half, that advantage. What are they doing here, Manchester United? Stam having to make amends for a fairly risky pass by Neville, but this is Dwight York. Van Nistelrooy and Giggs both making runs up front. Keane sprinting to the left here. Van Nistelrooy! Oh, and is it handball, Giggs? It hit the Liverpool player on the arm, and they're running up to the referee. David Beckham hands it aloft to Andy Durso. Also, Paul Scholes in the protest. Stefan Onsha, was it again? Well, if it was, Van Nistelrooy having a long, hard look at the referee as well, because he shaped there to score what would have been the equaliser. Well, it hits Stefan Onsha as he's falling, Mark.
Yeah, well, what the referee has to decide, John, is whether it was intentional or accidental, but I think Onsho's been lucky to get away with that. I think he stuck his arm out automatically and it flipped it.
Well, he had one in the FA Cup final, didn't he? He has had two today, and he's got away with them. If you consider that it should have been a penalty. This is Gary Neville. Andy Durso didn't. Now it's Owen. And Berger's just inside him. The last 5 minutes of matches these days, somehow or other, are much more exciting than they used to be. This is Giggs to Van Nistelrooy. What a good run. And he's still there. Just think David Beckham wanted that ball back, Mark.
He did. Just did a bit too much. I think once Van Nistelrooy was forced out wide, the Liverpool defence had done the job. Beckham was the option. But it all stemmed from a really good tackle down the bottom end from Dennis Irwin on Michael Owen.
It did indeed, yes, because Owen was threatening there. Now Bartes, a long kick forward, and they've never been outnumbered Liverpool here. This is Beckham, and if York had got hold of that, there was nobody near him. Beckham's gone down injured. York looks for Giggs. England captain on the ground. And that was a latest challenge as well. Oh, Scholes has got to be a little bit careful. He's already been booked. Andy Durso's having a word. The picture is on, the attention is on Beckham, who took a tumble there following that challenge. And this is Scholes. This is Dwight York. Left the ball behind, but didn't matter because Giggs picked it up. And they're really running at Liverpool now. Every Manchester United player is getting possession, is going for it. This is Irwin. Beckham. And Berger will intercept. And if he gets a chance to play the telling ball, Owen is to his left. But I don't think there's much other support. Beechjan. And he looks for Owen. Well, there are 3 minutes of the 90 to go, and you wouldn't put it past either side to score again. The game is so stretched. Here comes Barthez. York, who lost his footing there. Silvestre, play on, gigs to his left. Look at the appetite of David Beckham there on Dietmar Hamann. The last 2 minutes of the game, and he's relentless in the challenge. But he's conceded a free kick. But what an attitude. Premiership hasn't even started yet.
That shows you the feeling between these two sides and how much Manchester United don't want to be beaten again by Liverpool.
Well, there was a double over them last season, wasn't there? And now it's Heskey. Michael Owen, Heskey in the penalty area, waiting, here he comes. Now what's Barthez going to do? Anything is possible with him. He's found Scholes. Beckham. Giggs. In a really entertaining second half particularly. Keane to Scholes.
I think that was meant for Irwin. Yes, I think York just got in the way, really.
He did. Heskey. And he's gone down. It's play on. It's David Beckham. Oh, Scholes has got the other side of Babel. It's a corner to Manchester United. With just over a minute to go of normal time. And Barthez is coming up. Peter Schmeichel style. Beckham will plant it in. Can Manchester United force the game to a penalty shootout? Dwight York is there. And Liverpool happy to see that drop behind. Now what does Barthez do now,
well,
Mark?
Well, he's going to run back, Johnny, at the moment, Andy. But if you're going to come up, what's the point of coming up 35
halfway.
Yards from goal?
Yeah.
Get yourself in there.
Well, we are now in the 90th minute. I don't think we've seen a physiotherapist on the pitch, have we, Mark?
No.
Free kick to Liverpool. 2 minutes of added time. Clive Wilkes will be signalling in a moment. This is Berger. Taking on Neville. And pulling it back towards Heskey. Stan got a foot there first. Well, if Manchester United are going to save it, they've got to do it in stoppage time. Gary McAllister. Well, Barthez has now decided to come out of goal and play up the field. The Liverpool flags being waved around the Millennium Stadium as we enter the second and final minute of stoppage time. This is Dennis Irwin. The shot's on for him. Well, how the Liverpool supporters must love coming here. The Worthington Cup against Birmingham City. The FA Cup final against Arsenal. And the Charity Shield against perhaps their keenest rivals. Looks like going Gerard Houllier's way. Here's Owen. It's out. It's a goal kick.
Well, I wouldn't think there are too many neutrals in this ground, John, but for the few that are here, I think it's been an excellent game of football. Undoubtedly, Liverpool very much in the ascendancy the first half, but Manchester United come back so strongly in the second.
Yes, you could say they played it like a Premiership match, couldn't you? Goals has found York here. And we make it that the 2 minutes of stoppage time had elapsed. So Patrick Berger will just play for safety here. Carragher. Liverpool win the Charity Shield. Vesterveld in fine form in goal, and it had to be because Manchester United, beaten in this fixture for the fourth year running, were all, and there's a little argument going on with the referee here at the close of play. The assistants are having to protect him a little bit. Two or three Manchester United players went up, but there's a handshake or two also, and it's all died down a bit. Liverpool off to a flying start here. McAllister's penalty and Owen in the first 16 minutes. But then, particularly after Van Nistelrooy scored 6 minutes into the second half, Manchester United made a real match of it. It was high-octane entertainment underneath the roof in Cardiff, but it's another trophy for Gerard Houllier and Liverpool.
The FA Charity Shield is being presented to the Liverpool captain, Sammy Hibiya.
You seem to have started this season the way you finished last season.
I don't know. I hope so.
Winning things.
Winning things, but it doesn't, you know, I mean, I was pleased with the character we showed in the game. I thought we had a very good first half and probably managed to seal the result in the first half. But I thought Manchester United had a very, very attractive and very good second half. So we've got to give credit to the two sides. They produced a wonderful game of football today.
In the scheme of things, how relevant is that result?
Well, it's relevant because it's a kind of workout we needed. We needed that end-to-end game, a game where we put up the gas full blast. So I expect it to be bang on for next Sunday.
You seem very calm and relaxed, bearing in mind you should have had two penalty decisions.
Yeah, well, I mean, what can you say about referees? I mean, a good professional referee, these guys, but you need nerves to play in a big game. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're a player or an official. I think the lad is very nervous.
Frank Ferguson said that he expected Liverpool to start well. You didn't disappoint, did you?
Well, I think every team tries to start well. Obviously, the other team was trying to stop them, but it was nice to get an early lead and then to get another one after 20 odd minutes or so. We managed to hang on in the end. They obviously put us under pressure, but Man United do that to anyone.
Van Nistelrooy's arrival has caused you to tamper with the balance of the side. Is that going to take time to get it right, do you think?
Well, I think that in terms of using all of his abilities, we're still searching a little bit. But he is a great penalty box player. Oh, his quickness and movement in there. So we've got to make sure we get to that area of the field where it matters.
Sven, it was an interesting game. What did you make of that performance?
Well, there were many players for the England national team on the pitch today. And it was a very good game. I think Liverpool played very well first half, and United came back very strongly second half.
Heskey, superb. Owen, on form. It looks good for Liverpool this season.
We've got a good squad. Whoever plays, we know we're going to give our all, and we've got some character, we've got some desire to achieve, and I'm pleased for the boys that they got this Charity Shield.
A slight concern for England. Robbie Fowler, has he got a knock?
No, he'll be all right. No problem, he'll be all right.
Wednesday is another important game for England. What will you do? Will you experiment or will you be focusing on the result?
Now, both. The result is always important, even if it's a friendly game. And the performance is very important. It's the only chance we have to be together before the important German game, 1st of September.
Okay, that's it from us. More silverware then for Liverpool. We'll see you again on Wednesday. England versus Holland. Until then, get yourself to bed. Good night.